Hey everyone, I'm a 3D artist who uses Blender, and I'm not exaggerating when I say Topaz Studio was the addition to my workflow that most improved my final products and saved me time. I first heard about it when I saw a video where BEEPLE made one of his daily renders live. I've always liked some of the artistic effects of his work. Don't get me wrong, some of his stuff is just weird, but some of it's good. And when I saw how he took a boring render and added an effect to it with Topaz Studio, I had to check it out. Topaz Studio is one of several products created by Topaz Labs. It's a great tool for both photographers and digital artists. It's essentially a huge collection of powerful filters and masking tools that work non-destructively on your images. The filters by themselves are great, but the real power comes when you start combining them together, and the possibilities are endless. The very best part of Topaz Studio may be that it comes with a perpetual license. It's a one-time purchase with no recurring subscription costs. I'm not sponsored by Topaz, but I do have an affiliate link. If you try out Topaz Studio using my link, it pays me a few bucks at no extra cost to you, and it is greatly appreciated. So let's look at what you get with Topaz Studio and how it works. Go to the link in the description. You can currently buy Studio for a one-time cost, which is right now $99.99, or you can try it free for a month. It can be used as a standalone product or as a Photoshop plugin. If you use Photoshop, the plugin is convenient, but if you don't, you can still use all of the features of Topaz Studio. For a lot of things, it could honestly probably just replace Photoshop altogether. You can download a version for either Windows or Mac and install it. I'm going to cover both how to use it inside of Photoshop and as a standalone app. Inside of Photoshop, you select the layer that you want to apply a filter to. If you have multiple layers, duplicate everything and merge it into a single layer. It's a really good idea to have a duplicate layer as a backup. If you want to work non-destructively, you'll need to convert the layer to a smart object as well. Go to Filter, and down at the bottom, you should see Topaz Studio 2. Click it, and Topaz Studio opens up. If you're not using Photoshop, just find the Topaz Studio application on your computer and open it. Simply drag the image you want to edit into the workspace. At this point, it pretty much works the same whether you're using Photoshop or not. At the top, you have some pretty self-explanatory options, which we'll come back to. But the real magic is over here on the right in your effect layers. You have two options here to either add a filter or a look. I'm saving the best for last, so let's click Add Filter, and we see a long list of both basic and advanced filters. There's an essential category with more basic things that you can probably do in Photoshop, but this seems a lot easier. The creative and stylistic categories are the really fun ones. Clicking on any one of the filters adds it to the effect layer stack on the top right, and it opens up options below it. Every layer in your stack of effects will have an opacity setting, which adjusts how much the layer affects the image. But each will also have additional settings to play with down below. You can adjust to your liking. Or if you click down on the very bottom where it says Presets, you can choose from different presets that are already programmed into Topaz Studio. They may appear extreme at first, but you slide the amount slider to change how strong the preset effect is. Choosing apply will add the filter with the preset, and clicking the up arrow will discard the presets and bring you back to the manual settings. Next to each layer in the stack at the top, you have options to toggle the layer's visibility, delete the layer, or to mask the layer. If you choose mask, a mask icon appears next to the layer name, and the masking options appear below. You can select brush to manually paint where you don't want the effect. The strength, radius, and softness of the brush can be adjusted. This is what I use the most for masking. Or you can choose spot, which will give you sort of an adjustable vignette to mask out the effect. You can create a gradient for the effect, which is awesome. You can make color, luma, and other adjustments to your mask. All of these tools are super simple to use. I'm not a Photoshop wizard at all, but the controls in Topaz Studio are very intuitive, and I figured them out in just a few minutes. So whatever mask you have, you can adjust its overall effect with the opacity setting. You adjust between the mask controls and the layer controls by toggling the mask icon on the layer stack. You can add multiple filters on top of each other. As far as I can tell, there isn't really a limit to how many you can add, and you can fine-tune each one individually or turn them on and off to see their effects. You can reorder the effects by clicking the left icon and dragging them up or down. If you've ever worked with layers, you know that order can matter. There are tons and tons of things you can do with these filters. Focal blur, film grains, you can add text, glow effects, smudges, textures, and more. At any point, you can go to the top and toggle the button that says Original to go back and forth between what you've done to your image and viewing the original. These filters right here are worth the investment, in my opinion, but I haven't even gotten to the best part. If you've made it this far, hitting that like and or subscribe button would mean the world to me. Thank you. So what's the best part? I think it's the add look feature. Let's clear everything out, and instead of adding an individual filter, let's click add look. Here we can choose from tons and tons of pre-assembled looks to modify our image with just a click. I planned on counting the number of looks in Topaz Studio for this video, but it was so many that I gave up. Each look is a combination of filters, and in some cases textures as well, put together by people who are smarter and more artistic than I am. They can be viewed by category. You can save your favorites and view recently used looks as well. Just like with presets, their default intensity may be turned all the way up. Browse through the thumbnails until you see something you like and click on it. You can slide the amount slider back and forth. Maybe you're looking for a really subtle effect, or maybe you want something more dramatic. Get it where you want it and press apply. Don't worry, you can completely change everything later. This adds the entire look to your effects stack, with whatever individual filters it uses under them in a sublayer. We can click on the effect and adjust its strength by using the opacity slider, or we can click on an individual filter and make finer adjustments. On the abstract ones, you can change the stroke shape and tons of other things, but we're not done. You can keep adding looks on top of each other. Just click Add Look again and go find more to add to your stack. Once you play around with it, you'll find certain combinations that you like, I promise. When you do, you can press Save Look. Give your look a name and a description if you want, so you can easily find it later. In the future, this saved look will show up in the category called My Looks. I have sort of a routine I found where I first add a definition detail look to almost every one of my renders. This really brings out more detail in the render. Then I add something like bloom to make the color pop a little bit. Then I usually use one or more looks from the artistic category set at a very low strength. But how much of each effect I use completely depends on the image and what I'm going for on a particular project. One thing I should mention is even though you probably want to look at the entire image when you're adding filters and looks, looking at the image in a 1-to-1 scale is recommended. Apparently, if you don't, the effects you see in the preview could look different in the final product. So Topaz puts a fit and 100% icon at the top, so you can easily switch between viewing your entire image and viewing it at a 1-to-1 scale. If you want to save everything you have as a project you can keep working on later, either with the plugin or in the application, just go to File, Save Project. Save it, and then you can open it again with the Topaz Studio app and keep working on it later. When you're all done and want to export your final product, this works a little different depending on if you're in Photoshop or if you're using it in the Topaz application. Without Photoshop, you'll click Export. You can choose from a number of file types, give the image a name, tell it where you want it to be saved, choose your image quality and color profile, then click Export. It saves the image as instructed. If you're using the Photoshop plugin, you have the options of Cancel and Accept. Cancel will take you back to Photoshop with no changes saved. Accept will apply your changes and take you back into Photoshop. Some of the effects have a transparency element to them, so parts of your image might be see-through. And unless you put something in a layer below it, you'll have a transparent portion in your image. The duplicated image I recommended earlier usually works well as a background layer. Then you can adjust the strength of the filter again by adjusting the opacity of the top layer. And then you can keep doing whatever more you want in Photoshop. Unless you've saved your project in Topaz, I'm unaware of a way to open the filter back up in Photoshop and pick up from where you left off. Unfortunately, there's no way to add filters to video with Topaz Studio. I tried adding them to individual frames in bulk and it didn't work. So it's really just for still images and not video. Topaz Studio has seriously been one of the most worthwhile investments I've made, and I highly recommend it if you're looking to stylize your art or just make little improvements to things like color and lighting without an expensive subscription service. I'm a Blender user, and I used to spend so much time trying to create effects in the compositor and getting my lighting perfect on every render. Now I know that even a mediocre render can be made into a really awesome final product. It's like a magic button. Other products from Topaz Labs, if you're interested, include Topaz Video Enhance AI, which uses artificial intelligence to enhance the quality of video. Topaz Gigapixel allows you to enhance and enlarge images. Other programs include Denoise AI, Sharpen AI, Mask AI, and Adjust AI. As I said earlier, I've got an affiliate link in the description which costs you nothing but helps support my channel if you use it to purchase, or even if you just use it for a free trial. Giving the video a like would also mean the world to me. I do a lot of Blender content on my channel, but also stuff like this. If that's up your alley, consider hitting subscribe, and I would love to hear your questions or feedback in the comments. Thank you so much, take care, and stay creative. Thank you.